Hi friends, how are you all? Welcome to my channel. This is Fanaya Padabala. Please watch the videos till the end without skipping. You will get a basic information of the topic. So today my topic is an extension of the previous video about the meiosis one, and also I will discuss about the meiosis two also. So yesterday video I discussed about the meiosis one. In that meiosis one, I briefly discussed about the prophase one consisting of the five subdivisions. So like leptotin, zygotin, pachytin, diplotin and the diakinesis. So once again we will see the important points in that phase. So in that first one is the leptotin. So during this leptotin, a thin thread like chromatin will form, and in the zygotin a pair of chromosomes come in to form a synapse, or the homologous chromosomes or the bivalent or synaptonemal complex will form. And in the pachytin, there is a crossing wall takes place. At that point we are called as chiasma or the chiasmata. The ribokinesis enzyme is responsible for the formation of the chiasmata. And in the diplotin, there is an repulsion of the chromosomes will take place, and still they are attaching each other at the tip. And finally, in the diakinesis, a nuclear membranes and the nucleolus disappear, and the centrosome splits into centrioles. So along with this formation of the spindle fibers by the presence of the esterase, and these homologous chromosomes starts separating and also attaching with the spindle fiber by the presence of the kinetochore. And the next one is a continuation is a metaphase, anaphase and the telophase. So during the metaphase, these homologous chromosomes lies in the equatorial plate by the presence of the kinetochore, the kinetochore which will help in the momenting of the chromosomes through the spindle fibers. And in the anaphase, disjunction of chromosomes will take place. So these homologous chromosomes starts separating and it moves to the opposite folds. And the next one is the telophase. So during the telophase, a nuclear membranes reappear along with the nucleolus and the centrosome, and also it is followed by the cytokinesis process, resulting in the formation of the two haploid cells, that is the end product of the meiosis one. So these two daughter cells now participate in the meiosis two. Meiosis two is similar to the mitosis process. It is not like a meiosis one. In the meiosis one, the prophase consisting of five divisions. So like this, in the meiosis two is not there. It's like a mitosis process having the prophase two, metaphase two, anaphase two, and the telophase two. So in the prophase two, a disappearance of the nuclear membranes, nucleolus, and the centrosome split into centrioles moves to the opposite folds. You can observe in the diagram here. And in the metaphase two, these chromosomes, they are lies on the equatorial plate by the presence of the kinetochore. And the next one is anaphase. Now the sister chromatids will move to the opposite poles in the anaphase. And in the telophase, again division will take place followed by the cytokinesis. Again the reappearance of the nucleus, nuclear membranes and the nucleolus along with the centrosome. Finally resulting in the formation of four haploid cells having the off number of chromosomes. So meiosis process takes place in the reproductive cells or the germ cells. Example, sperm cells in the males and the egg cells in the females. So resulting in the formation of four haploid cells consisting of half number of chromosomes. So this is about the meiosis one and the meiosis two. So I already completed the cell cycle about the interphase and the mitosis, and the meiosis one and two also completed everything. If you are having any doubt regarding this topic, you can comment it in the comment box. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel, like my channel and comment my channel. Give some suggestions in the form of comments. Have a nice day. Take care. Bye bye and keep smiling. Love you.